He was the handyman with the sort of social media profile that said, "Trust me, I'm your guy." The sort that would happily do all those smallest jobs that are difficult to get done.
But the bloke smiling and working hard in the videos became a very different person once he got the money. So, where is he now? That's another big surprise. Garth's been on the hunt.
If you've hired a handyman to fix up your place, this is exactly what you'd want to see. A crew hard at work, getting the job done. A boss more than happy to show his face. Auckland contractor Ian Uhatahi and his Facebook Lives have given people confidence to part with money in advance.
So 21,000 off the, 26.
That's 80% of the contract Carrie and Estelle agreed for a new driveway, a fence and a small rock wall.
I think I'm a good judge of character, but this time it failed me.
Looking at the truck, it looks like they've been in business for a while, you know. So you think, yeah, OK. And people just let you down.
Let down doesn't come close for Carmen.
Well, I'm really embarrassed to say it, but he's got $6,000 of mine. Yes. Can beat that out if you want. I feel a little silly that someone has taken my money, and but I don't want him to do it to other people.
Because many months on, no more diggers, no sign of the crew, no more Ian Uhatahi Facebook Lives from these work sites, and no word of why.
This part of the job was going to be 10, so I don't know. That included the concrete down here as well.
Okay.
And 16 from up there down to here.
Right.
That's the 26,000. Remember, they'd already handed over 21,000 of that.
Crikey.
Yeah, the day before the concrete was coming, and I come home and I thought, they should be here, throwing the rest of the boxing in. There's nobody here, so the alarm bell started ringing. So I said to Estelle, "Ring the concrete guys." And the guy said, "Yep, it's been ordered, but it's not been paid for."
"We will deliver once you pay for it." And I was like, this guy's sitting with our money since the beginning of March.
Carmen had started Ian Uhatahi cautiously with a small job.
So this was your wall?
Yeah, it's the great wall of Rangiriri.
With this wall,
yeah,
he built your confidence?
Yeah.
Carmen then offered the handyman a bigger project at her place that hasn't gone so well.
Okay, oh, nice doorstop.
Yeah, quite a large doorstop actually.
And nice deck.
Yeah, lovely. It's a bit hard perching on the post having my cup of tea.
The job was supposed to take about a week.
Yep, I'm happy with that. When can you start and when can you finish?
So many people ask when can you start. How many people ask when can you finish? Not that many. So well done already.
Well, tried to be on the ball.
Carmen is no pushover. It hadn't just been $6,000 in advance. She'd also been very direct up front. Listen and learn.
Gave me a price, and I said to him, "Are you sure that this is going to cover everything? Because I don't want to have an awkward conversation with you either during the time that you're building it or at the end where you're going to go, oh, actually, I haven't covered my costs, I need some more money." I said, "Because it's probably going to be more awkward for you when I say no."
That's a pro talking. Building her deck in December for Christmas was the final test of the handyman before she employed him in her day job as a property manager.
So there was every reason for him to do the best he could.
Yeah. Finding good trades, there's lots out there, but they're also super busy. And so when you find them, then you stick to them, especially in property management, because they do help you out of tight spots.
This one still looked pretty tight. At the same time, Carrie and Estelle's job had just stalled after they spotted negative feedback on the same Facebook community pages where they'd found their contractor.
On Facebook, there's three other people that we held.
I went on Messenger and I said, "Oh, Ian, please don't tell me this is true." And that, it feels like that sort of triggered him. And that's when all this happened, we stopped.
So what had happened? Why had a seemingly busy contractor vanished with other people's money in his pockets for work unfinished? His customers, his companies, or the places they were registered to, they're all a short drive down State Highway 1, mostly around Pukekohe. With a disconnected phone number and no reply to emails, we hit the streets for any trace.
Just up the road is one address where Ian Uhatahi registered a company. The people living there say they know him. They say he owes them money. They say he owes other people money and they come calling from time to time. but that Ian Uhatahi himself hasn't lived at the address for quite some time, so we need to keep looking.
And I'll be leaving the camera crew outside again, no point hassling innocent bystanders.
Right, so it turns out the person that used to live there maybe knows Ian. Certainly they're on documents for the company that they helped create, but they haven't been there for quite some time.
We're spreading the net wider.
Someone here might know someone who knows Ian. See if they're home.
Like with fishing, you have to be patient.
Well, there's no one home here, so we left a note. We're trying.
And diving deeper into those records for a second company deregistered 15 years ago. Buried in those records a mobile number and a name.
Yes, Susan? Susan from Uhatahi Services?
Yeah, Garth Bray from Fairgo.
No, I promise I'm not a scammer. How can I prove that? How about I take a photo? I'll just get some help.
Hey guys, need some help? Can you just wave to Susan?
Susan, ready? I'll take a picture. Hi. I'm sending it through now, okay?
You know this chap, Ian Uhatahi, who we're trying to get a hold of?
Okay, so you have never lived in Auckland. You've never heard of this person. You've never given him your phone number.
Right, good talking to you, Susan.
It was Susan Uhatahi, except it wasn't. That was her first name, but not her last name. It was the right phone number, but she has never heard of this company, this man, never lived at any of those addresses, and sent me some evidence that suggests that's the case. So it looks like another dead end in the search for Mr. Ian Uhatahi. Weird.
But persistence pays. I get a call from one of those places we visited. They helped Ian Uhatahi get started in business. They'll try to help us talk to him. They say he now has my number, he just hasn't used it yet. We have found some more traces on yet more Facebook pages. We can try to place a video call.
Straight away, just denied because we're not friends and the account doesn't allow new message requests from everyone.
Same for a business Facebook listing, but it all takes us closer to the elusive Ian Uhatahi. We've been keeping tabs on his travels. Here is where we've found him. That is downtown Nuku'alofa, the capital of Tonga. Looks like he's being taken for a ride.
Shut.
Another day, looks like he's supervising some construction work. He's keeping an eye on some land and enjoying the day's catch. Nice for him.
There's my driveway.
What about his customers back in Auckland?
You trust. I think that's what we did, and yeah, it burned us.
At some point, you've got to trust people if you're gonna do stuff, but everybody works hard, well, most people, to get their money. So it shouldn't just be someone's right to come along and scam it off them. And I just want him to stop and to expose him, and then hopefully it'll save someone else from losing their hard-earned money.
Oh, there's a lot of words I've got for Ian, but my te reo isn't quite up with the play in that area, so I'm just going to say tēnō kino, which means that is pretty poor, and that's very mild.
Yes, it is. So come on, Ian, get in touch. We know you're big on social media, and Garth is standing by right now watching our inbox. And if you know Ian or want to share anything with us, don't slam it on the public page. Our DMs are open.